Hi friends, welcome to my channel IT Smart Training. Today IT Smart Training showing you how to move mailbox one database to another database using Exchange Server 2019. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get more up to date. Let's start a lab. First, I just want to tell you this task will be done by using Exchange Admin Center as well as Exchange Management Console or Exchange Management Shell. Mailbox are stored, we all know that mailbox are stored into the database. The database extension of that mailbox is .edb. And our objective is to moving mailbox into one database to another, means one EDB file to another EDB file. So here you can see that if I go to the server and then under database, you can see that there is only one database is created over here because this is a default database. So I create two separate database. I just go to the Exchange server and the under C drive I create two folder. First folder is name is DB1. Another one is DB2. Okay. Then I just create a new database named DB1 mailbox server is EX1 and I will store the database under this location C drive DB1. This is the location of my database and as well as the configuration file also stored under here and I just saved. Done. I have to restart the Exchange Store service. I will do it after a few minutes. Okay. So I create another database named DB2, and I store my mailbox server. I just select the mailbox server name and store it under this path. I was created the folder name DB2. Okay, and as well as I just change this path also DB2. Okay, so save. So here is a giving a warning, please restart the Exchange information store service. I just select OK. go to the Exchange server. Go to run services.msc. Just restart the Microsoft Exchange Information Store service. Now, I just go to the recipient and create a user mailbox. Named test one. The mailbox server is new user. New user test one. Provide the password. Test one. Save. Test one is created. Now I just check. I did a mistake, that is I cannot select the mailbox server. Just ignore this user. I create another user. I did a little mistake over there. So that's why I create a new user. Test 2. Test 2. Test 2. Provide password. Go to more option. Here you select the mailbox. Okay. I select mail DB1 is the mailbox. And the archive mailbox, no need to configure yet. Just save. So here you can see my mailbox is created under the DB1. Go to the Exchange server. I just open the Exchange Management Shell. You can see that the database is DB1. There you can see the user is created. Go to the Exchange server once. Here I type a command get-mailbox. Database name is DB1. If first get mailbox database. Here you can find that I have three mailbox database over here. So next mailbox database name db1. Space pipe sign get mailbox. See, you can see that inside the DB1 there is a single database, a single mailbox, that is TS2. And if you find here to DB2, you cannot find anything inside the mailbox because DB2 is right now empty. So I just go to the Exchange Control Panel. Now I want to move this. In the right pane, you can see Move Mailbox. There is an option Move Mailbox to another database. Select this one. Move DB1 to DB2. I want to move DB1 to DB2. Here is some archive option. Move the primary mailbox and archive mailbox if R exist. Move primary mailbox only without moving the archive mailbox. Move archive mailbox only without moving the primary mailbox. There are three options available. So I just select the first option over here and target database. Where to move? I want to move this database. TS2 resides inside the DB1. I just move into DB1 to DB2 and add. Okay. This is also DB2. If I have an archive mailbox. Right now I don't have any archive mailbox yet. Next. Here is the administrator. Who is the administrator? And next. Yes. So DB1 to DB2 is syncing. Migration process is started. If you want to check, just select the view details. Is validating. If you want to report, we just download the report for user. This is a text file. Now right now this is a blank because this is still working. It'll take few minutes to move.